Yo, welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. Welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. Welcome to Manifest Monday. Welcome to Manifest Monday. I definitely can't stay too long. I got a meeting in a couple minutes. But I want to hop on real quick and set the vibe. I'm gonna hop off, show y'all what my morning started off like with Corey trying to kill us this motherfucking morning. But I'm gonna name this video fucking Megan Knees, bitch, Megan Knees. But this is the vibe for the day. This is the time to go, you know, get all of your shit, whatever it is, Molly's Buns Perks, whatever it is that you use to get your day started or wind your day down. And we're gonna set the vibe for the motherfucking day, and then we're gonna make some shit. I'm gonna make you do what you do, baby. It's my shit. One of my favorite songs. British welcome to Pastor Donnie McLaughlin.
Lord, you promise if I keep my mind on you, you keep me in perfect. You keep me in perfect.
Got this charge on my phone and it's doing stupid shit.
If I call upon your name,
hey,
you never turn away from me. No, no, you never turn away from me. I said you give me everything.
These my workout hoops. Hey,
you give me everything I need. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Y'all forgive all of my camera moving today. Be like that sometimes.
Lord, you promise if I keep my mind on you, you keep me in perfect peace. You keep me in perfect peace. Oh, when I sit still, and I call upon your name, you never turn away from me. No, you never turn away from me. So you give me everything I need. You give me everything I need.
All right, guys. Yo, welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. Welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. Welcome to the neighborhood. If it's your first time in the neighborhood, I gotta give you some community rules. I gotta give you some rules to navigate the neighborhood. If it's your first time in the neighborhood, please make sure you bring it back. Bring it back to the bottom of the map. Make sure you go all the way back to the very beginning and watch a video called Welcome to the Neighborhood. It's the very first video that I ever uploaded. It's a little awkward like me, but just do it. Just lean into it. Watch from Welcome to the Neighborhood in chronological order until the point you came in on the journey. So that's Welcome to the Neighborhood, which is the first video, then watch the second video, then the third video, then the fourth video, then the fifth video, then the sixth video, all the way until the point you came in on the journey. What's the point you came in on the journey? I'm so glad you asked. The point you came in on the journey is the video that you clicked that introduced you to me, that said, who is this girl? What is she talking about? Am I interested? Do I want to like, share, or subscribe, or do I want to thank you next? I ask. Do I want to just click off this shit? You need to know that here in the neighborhood, we follow two people. First, always being God. As for me and my house, we serve the Lord. I don't give a fuck who you serve. I don't give a fuck if you don't serve anybody. This is a no judgment zone. In the words of the ghetto nun, all are motherfucking welcome. All are motherfucking welcome here. And then second, we follow Uncle Luke. We don't stop. We pop that pussy. We keep going past the point we came in a journey. We watch into the very last video that has been uploaded, if that's still an option. I like to tell people this is the story of a girl and God, and you get to watch wherever I'm motherfucking going. You get to watch wherever I'm motherfucking going. If you want to know a little bit about the channel and why I am doing what I'm doing, make sure you go and see a video called A Thing About Hope, The Thing About Hope. I can never fucking remember, but I know it's a part one and part two, so make sure you watch the both of them. Every little bit helps. All right. All right, y'all see I'm talking fast because I got a lot of shit to do. Bitch, and a little bit of time to do it in. All right, guys. So today is Manifest Motherfucking Monday. Today is Manifest Monday. Today, the name of today's video is Megan Thee's Hot Girl Summer. So you know it's gonna be lit. So with that being said, I'm gonna pop off and pop back on. Let me show y'all how my morning started with Corey giving us this crazy ass workout. But I feel good. I feel great. I got a lot of fucking energy. I'm tired and sleepy at the same time. I feel like I'm on uppers and downers, bitch. I don't know. But so this is how my motherfucking morning started. This the energy that I got. And this is how like I plan for today to keep motherfucking going. Like this. Okay, let's try it again. Like this.
In the last week of January, we're gonna do build, which is more about building strength and muscle. Okay. So today, this is what we're doing. We have the exercise here. I'm going to demonstrate each exercise. Then you guys are gonna work at your own pace, but at a certain amount of time.
All right, welcome back. Like we never left. Like you don't even know we went anywhere. But yeah, that was my workout this morning. And we did a class. I signed up for a class. And so at my gym, we have free classes for 1 month, for the month of January. So I'm going to sign up for the free. I signed up for the free classes, and I will actually sign up for the paid classes as well. But definitely taking advantage of the free classes. So it's very beneficial. As Corey said, it's just like I take advantage of it. So I'm going to do probably two a day tomorrow. I'm going to go in the morning, and then I'm going to go at night. And then so that's two of my workouts for the week that I like that I get to do. And then with somebody, and then I get to work by myself. I genuinely don't like, or generally don't like, to work in groups. But today was a good class. It was a good group of people, so I'm definitely gonna make sure I go again. We definitely stayed socially distanced. We definitely made it pop. So that there's that. But today being Manifest Monday, I told y'all yesterday that I overbooked myself. I didn't overbook myself. I just booked myself back to back like motherfucking Drake. But random. So the reason why I'm calling this video Megan Thee's is because in our workout, so really quickly going back to the, so my workout today, we had to do different reps. You'll hear Corey talk about we had different reps. We had three sets, three different, it was a base workout, and we had three different sets. And then three reps within those sets. And one of them was this resistance band. And I told him one of my goals is to ride Bay Dick for an hour. And so we put these bands on, and I'm exhausted. I'm super fucking exhausted. I'm tired. like, I'm just like, I can't go no more, because we only had 20 seconds in between each rep. And we did a lot of shit. So he comes up to me. He was just like, "You want the Megan Thee's? You want the Megan Thee's? This gonna help you get the Megan Thee's." And so I just keep going. Like, I'm hurting, I'm tired, but I keep going, and I keep going as hard and with the same wherewithal as when I first started, because I have a goal. I'm trying to manifest Megan motherfucking Thee's. I'm trying to ride the dick for an hour. I'm trying to ride it for an hour. So I gotta do, what are you willing to do to ride the dick for an hour? And I know that sounds like a silly, you know, motivation, but it don't be so small mind to just think that it's something as silly as just riding a dick for an hour. But it's something that gives us drives. It's something that makes us keep going. What is that thing for you? So my motivation for today is Megan Thee's. So I guess my motivation Monday for you guys today is, you're going to get tired as you're manifesting. You're going to be worn out. You're going to, like, especially depending upon the amount of seeds that you plant, you're going to be back to back. You're going to be somebody, man. I remember when I took my motherfucking my Spectrum boxes back, the man at the place, he told me, I'm too blessed to be stressed and too anointed to be disappointed. Like, when you plant so many motherfucking seeds, like, you're going to be going back to back. But I'm too blessed to be stressed and too anointed to be disappointed. So yeah, I like, to whom much is given, much is required. And that's the kind of thing that's coming to for today's Manifest Monday. Whatever you want is going to take a lot of work, and you're going to be tired, and you're going to be weary, and you're going to want to stop. But sometimes God will send a little angel on your way and say, "Megan Thee's." Never forget Megan Thee's. Like, what do you want? Like, is this what you want? Is this what you want to do? Is this what you want to go? You said you wanted this thing. How bad do you want it? How bad do you want what you say you want? Because I'm gonna give you a seed, but you gotta water it, you gotta nurture it, and And God, when he bless you, he bless you. He pour you out a blessing. You won't have room. He'll pour you out a blessing that your cup will overflow. But you got to nourish and nurture those blessings. And so that takes work. That takes time. That takes energy. So do you have the wherewithal? Do you have to go get them? Do you have to push it to keep going when you tired? Do you have to push it to keep going when you want to give up, when you feel like you can't keep going? And to keep going with that same motherfucking enthusiasm that you started with. It's Manifest Monday. When you manifesting things, you gotta keep that. One of my homegirls always say, keep that same energy. Keep that same motherfucking energy. Keep them Meganese. What do you want? Meganese. I was hitting that shit. Now I feel like my leg's about to fall off, bitch. But when I, y'all, trust me, I'm gonna put a Meganese part 2 up, bitch. Y'all gonna be like, all right, manifest. But I'm manifesting the life. I'm manifesting. They shouldn't. Why is they texting me back on this one? I don't know what I did. But it's so funny. So today my family started our fitness challenge. And somebody just texted me back. I'm assuming that you left my niece and my little brother off because they didn't want to participate. Absolutely. They was like, fuck that shit. They was like, I'm not doing it. My little brother was like, I already wanted. My little niece was like, that don't even sound fun. But they gonna be saucy when we find this fuck, and they not. Well, my little brother said he already won. So that part, which he did, because he do look good. But that's not the motherfucking point. But Meganese, like, what are you willing to do to get what you want in this life? And I know that sounds like a reoccurring thing. I know that sounds like I keep reinforcing that, but I'm gonna say it to you. I'm gonna hit it from every different angle so that you can really get what the fuck it is that I'm telling you, what I'm trying to fucking say to you. Manifest what you want. But when you manifest what you want, sometimes it's gonna hurt. Sometimes it's gonna take all of the energy. Like, that's the late nights or early mornings that I was telling you guys about yesterday. What are you doing to manifest good people in your life, manifest good energies in your life? Everybody in that class had great energy. Shout out to the young girl, her name Nikki. It was so funny, and gotta put people in your place, because I put on my hoodie. I got a shirt on under this, but I put on my hoodie. And she was just like, oh, you from Louisiana? I'm from Louisiana too. And it's so crazy because I'm in Charlotte and I'm meeting more Louisiana people than I'm meeting Charlottesians. And so that shit crazy as well. But like, that's how you know you in the right motherfucking place. That's how you know you're doing what you're supposed to. Like, when you start to see a little bit of growth, when you start to see all of that shit, then that's how you know you in the right fucking place. That's how you know when your manifestation is working out. When you got more energy than you started with, that's how you know that you're doing what you're supposed to be doing. Like, everybody be trying to figure out how you know, because you know, you can tell a tree by the fruit that it bear. I told y'all should be able to look at a person and look at a thing and say it's from God just by looking at it. A person, a place, a thing shouldn't have to say it. The energy that it gives off should be able to tell you that it's in alignment with your life or it's not in alignment with your life. And so really quickly, I want to talk about some astrology things. What time is it? 33. We got this new moon, I always forget to shout her out, but Coyote Star, she my go-to, bitch. Like, she, like, because one of, I manifest, so, really quickly, so, a good time to manifest is to set your intentions through the new moon, and so that's your goal marker. That's how I mark my goals. That's how I use the moon to mark my goals. And maybe my next Manifest Monday, I'll go deeper into how to use astrology to manifest the things that you want in your life. This Capricorn moon on the 13th is a perfect moon to start manifesting. And you guys, people who are new to spirituality, like, it's not magic. So, like, just because you write something on this moon or you do something on this moon doesn't mean that it's going to happen. It takes work. You know, God to give you a seed, you got to plant it and water it. But energies are fluid. And so what that means is the energy is just not potent on that day. It's potent the day before. It's just like, it goes with the flow. It's like water. It's everywhere all at once, and it kind of whittles out, like, until it's just not there anymore. But the energy is probably there now. So if you want to start writing down your intentions, and intentions are simply, what are things that you want to bring into fruition? What are things that you want to actively work on to bring them to life? Write that shit down. Do that shit. That's how, like, that's how I manifest. And you don't have to write it. Sometimes people, like, how do you, and so knowing what type of learner you are, knowing how you need to learn how you manifest. Everybody does not manifest the same. Some people write it, some people speak it, some people think it, some people see it. It just depends. So you already know I do experiments on myself, and so I can think things. I literally don't have to write them. I can just think them, and it freaks me out because I'm like, oh, I just thought about that, and that shit just boom, it's there. But like, I like to submit it. I like the whole process. I already said, think it, say it, write it. Think it, say it, write it. Think it, write it, say it. Whatever it is, it just depends on what it is that you're trying to bring into fruition. So I use the new moon to really set my intention. So if you really, like, I don't do New Year's resolutions, but if you really want to start to set goals and plan, start on the new moon. And it's a full, and so the full moon cycle, the moon cycle is how you check yourself. Okay, new moon to new moon. You have a new moon every month. Look at your list, check, reassess, what have you accomplished, what have you, and you, sometimes you want to accomplish all of these things at once. Like, sometimes, it, like I told y'all, manifesting takes years sometimes. It just depends on what it is that you're trying to manifest. But what steps have you taken during the next new moon or the next full moon? What steps have you taken? So, the full moon is to really check to see what you've done and how much work have you done to bring the thing into fruition. What's your progress? It's a progress check. And the new moon is it's like, once you've done your progress check, I would use the new moon to rewrite and revise. Okay, so I've done this much. I can keep going here, or I need to change and things like that. So that's happening on the 13th. It's supposed to be a period of darkness. I need to do a little bit more research, and not darkness in a negative sense, but the way the planets are aligned, we have some conjunctions going on right now. The way the planets are aligned, which they are all, it's a whole bunch of planets aligned right now. The way the planets are aligned, this is the time for, like, you won't see a lot of action. This is the time for the behind the scene work. Like, Mars is in Taurus, so Mars is, it was just in Aries, so it was going. And so now it's in Taurus, now it's about doing the work. So now it's planting the seeds, tilling the garden, watering, planting the seeds, tilling the garden, watering. And you won't see any action. You won't see any buds or any sprouts or anything that you, from you planting the seeds and watering the seeds until March. And March is not that seed coming into fruition. It's just the bud breaking the dirt, because a lot of people don't understand when they plant a seed, they like, it's shit going on underneath the surface before it ever break the ground. You know what I'm saying? So right now we're doing the groundwork. Right now is the groundwork, and that's how you use this energy. If you're using this energy wisely, I would tell you right now is a great time to really, because it's a lot of as far as the planets go, it's a very potent time to really plant seeds. Like, if there is a fertile ground for, if there was ever a time to plant seeds and have a Jack and a Magic Beanstalk ass plant, now is the time. Plant your spiritual seeds and watch them grow into something great. But you have to do the work even when you don't see the progress. You gotta have Meganese right now. This is the time for Meganese. And by March, you're gonna start to see, like, maybe I can't do it on the dick for an hour, but I could definitely peep pop for a good 10 minutes. I could definitely, but you won't start to see that until March. But the only way you'll see that in March is if you do the motherfucking work now. Are you willing to do the work now? I'm gonna run that Hot Girl Summer. That's how what I'm gonna take us out on real quick. Come on, Donnie McClurkin want to run again. All right, I need to do that for. Donnie McClurkin wants to run. Let's make it work. So that's a little bit about the planets. That's a little bit about astrology. Somebody said, and this is probably going to be extremely controversial, especially in astrology community. I'm going to look at squares differently, because people look at squares. I don't like to look at anything in a negative concept. Everything is all about how you believe it works for you. So, Uranus is squaring, Capricorn is squaring Aquarius right now. And so Uranus is in Taurus and it's in retrograde. That's the only planet we have in retrograde right now. But Mercury is about to go retrograde. So be mindful of your electronics. Be mindful of your communication. Be mindful of your travel plans. Check everything twice. What time is it? Okay, good. I got enough time to run upstairs. But so Uranus is in retrograde and it's squaring Aquarius, and everybody is really worried about, you know, how that's okay. I'm sorry. Y'all already know I got meetings. Everybody is really worried about how Aquarius and Uranus will work with each other, but I think they're going to play very well. Because when something squares each other, they think of that as conflict. But first off, I think of that as resistance training. But Uranus is my, I come to fuck it up, pop star. That's my, Uranus is pop star. If you think about Uranus, go listen to the Drake pop star song. I came to fuck it up. Yeah, that's Uranus. And Aquarius, but Aquarius is like, they call him the Mad Hatter. So think of Alice in Wonderland, the Mad Hatter. He came to fuck it up. So like, while people think that Aquarius and Uranus are going to be conflicted with each other, I'm thinking like, how can we make these motherfuckers work for the best? So what about Aquarius? Aquarius is the unorthodox, it's the out the box thinker, it's the creative, it's the innovator, it's the Steve Jobs of the world, and it's with a person who is meeting with a planet that's unorthodox. They play well together. They can play well together. But you just got to think of it like that. So wherever Aquarius and Uranus is in your chart, it's about to get interesting. But it's a lot of different other aspects that go with that as well. But neither here nor there. So with that, I'm excited about Uranus and Aquarius. I'm excited about Uranus going direct on the 14th. And it's stationing direct. It's not even going direct. So it's just stopping the appearance of going backward. And it's starting to go forward. So it's about to be something like, I think of Uranus as whatever happens is going to be beautiful. And Aquarius is the, you know, it's all about helping the community. It's all about everybody else. It's all about the well-being of the state of the union. So I think that my prediction or my idea is that the idea with the Aquarius, with Aquarius being in Saturn being in Aquarius, is that Uranus is square Saturn, which is in Aquarius, and Uranus is in Taurus, Saturn is in Aquarius. I think they're going to work together well, but I think that this is the time, the quote where the first will be last and the last will be first. This is where the first, if we're thinking about track terms or track terminology, this is where the person or the place or the thing that appeared to be, like, if you know anything about track, like, you got to know how to pace yourself in track, and appearances are everything, because we got Neptune on some crazy ass shit. So Neptune make everything, it's like the thing in your mirrors that says things are more closer than they appear. Like, it's not what it appears to be. So like, when the first become last and the last become first, it's the things, it's the people, it's the places that look like, if you're in, we're using that track analogy, that look like it, but it's the beginner, but they look like they know what they're doing. So they out the gate going, they giving all they got. They don't know how to pace yourself. When you have Megan knees, you got to know how to pace yourself. When you're manifesting, you have to know how to pace yourself, because the pro knows that, but the beginner, he just want to get out there and make it look good. But the reality is, by the time if we doing the mile relay, if you didn't pace yourself correctly, then by the time you get to that last lap, the person that has paced themselves and watched you run too fast, they start to pass the other one up slowly but surely. So when Uranus goes direct, this is when the person or the beginner, I hope this makes sense, the beginner, he starts to slow down. He starts to get tired because he hadn't paced himself. But the pro, but the one that was last, but the one that was watching you tire yourself out because they knew you didn't know what you were doing, they start to pick up the pace. This is when they get their gas. And you tired now. So there's that. So that's what I think about what's going on. And so that's why I think it's very important. Like, everybody tired. Like Corey was saying, we up at 6 o'clock in the morning. Sun not even out. Niggas still in their bed sleep. They talked about they wanted to work out, but we working out. So this is where as the peace dealer would say, I'ma email him. That's what my spirit tell me. I'ma email him and see what he say. But this is where you tell the wheat from the tares. The people who talk about it against the people who want to be, who really about it. Hello, somebody. All right, I'm gonna run this song and then I gotta go upstairs and set up for my meeting and get myself some tea. I'm gonna let the video run so you can hear the Megan Nees analogy. Y'all have a blessed day. Happy Manifest Monday. Go get it, because if you don't, you already know. You already fucking know.
Calling all hotties. You're invited to the hottest pool party of the summer. Be there. Okay. Hey, ladies, free. I'm not having a productive hot girl summer. But guess what? You have time to make it up.
What would Megan do?
My sister calling. Baby, let me roll on you. She gets. Megan, these not strong like yours. Vibrate your knees. Baby, let me roll on you. Alright, forget it. I'll just ask for the knees for Christmas.
Just ask for the knees for Christmas. Megan knees, vibranium knees. Straight like this. Give a fuck about a nigga, ayy.
What you say?
Happy Five Girl Summer, so you know it's gonna be lit. Real ass bitch, hey. So you know she kinda lit. You won't have no me, hey. He a member on the team, hey.
I told him ain't no taming me. I love my niggas equally. I
Should I take that dick? Hey, give a fuck about a bitch, hey. She a big old freak, so hot girl summer, so you know it's gonna be.